The time is 6:39, just about 67 degrees on a Sunday morning. Now the Veterans Memorial Park in DeForest has received a makeover just in time for Memorial Day. Here to tell us all about Memorial Day ceremonies is Dan Jardine. Okay, thank you so much for coming in. Now this is the first year the Marines are putting this on, right?
That's right.
Of which you are a veteran of the Marines.
That's true.
Tell us a little bit about how that came to be.
Well, at the Veterans Park, we honor all branches of service. We've had ceremonies there. This will be the fourth year. Last year, after the ceremonies, I went to the Marine Corps ceremony at the Drill Center. And afterwards, me and some other Marines thought, you know what, we should let the general public see some of the Marine ceremony and tradition at a Memorial Day ceremony. So that's what we're going to do tomorrow.
So you guys are close to completing this park, and the park has a lot of things, a lot of features that are recognizing our veterans and our fallen heroes here.
It's a unique and exciting park. We have granite stones commemorating each of the five branches of the service, telling the public a little bit about each of those branches of service. And we're putting in historic pieces to recognize those various branches of the service. Just this week, we put in a World War I cannon on behalf of the Army. And we have a Coast Guard buoy that was in Lake Michigan for quite some time, and we're looking for other pieces to commemorate the other branches of the service.
Talk about the Walk of Heroes.
We have a Walk of Heroes that has bricks in it, and the bricks are available for engraving the name of any veteran, past or present, from any place in the country, any branch of the service, to memorialize the veterans.
And there's a Fallen Heroes Memorial as well for heroes from the DeForest area, right?
That's right. It's called the Fallen Comrades Memorial. It's a beautiful sculpture that acknowledges the sacrifices given by the DeForest area veterans with their names on it.
When do you think the park will be complete?
Well, in light of the fact that we made some really big additions just this past week, we are really close. It's our hope that we can do so by the end of this year.
Okay. So tell us a little bit about the ceremonies coming up tomorrow.
Well, we will have Marines there of every generation from the present all the way back to and including World War II, believe it or not.
And that's a woman, right?
That's right. Yes, she was an air traffic controller in the Marines. And I haven't met her yet, quite frankly. And I was trying to set things up and was asking, how close do I need to sit her next to things? And they're like, don't worry, she could still be in the Marines today. So I'm really looking forward to meeting her.
Okay, what else you got going on?
Well, we'll have Marines in dress blues with a rifle detail, a lot of other surprises that I don't want to tell people about until they get there. But I honestly believe we will have as memorable and unique a ceremony as, quite frankly, any place in the country. We're going to be putting together a life-size replica of a fallen warrior memorial that is sitting outside of the Marine Corps Drill Center in Madison with Marines from every generation. And we'll be acknowledging sacrifices given by all members of all branches of the service.
So the ceremony is tomorrow, 11:45 North Main Street in DeForest.
Yes, and it will start promptly at 11:45, and you should get there early because you might have to walk a bit to get there.
All right, sir. Thank you for coming on.
Hey, thanks for having
us. Thank you for your service, and the time is 6:42. And keep it here. We'll be right back with weather headlines and events.